Welcome to Powering Up Your Yamaha CP Electric Grand Piano Safely. This is part two in the series, Inside the Power Supply and Internal Electronics. In part one, we covered the specifications of the external Yamaha CP power supply and had a brief look at the internal power supply circuitry. In this segment, we'll cover what's inside the external power adapter and how it and the internal regulator circuitry work together to power up the piano. If you haven't seen part one, I recommend you do so before watching this video. When we use a digital multimeter to measure the DC voltage of this power supply before it's plugged into the piano, it measures over 19 volts, much higher than what's printed on the label. What's up with that? Why is the voltage so high? Well, in order to answer that question satisfactorily, we'll have to learn some rules about unregulated power supplies and why they behave this way. What is their design? How do they behave? And what are their limitations? This is a schematic diagram of the unregulated power supply contained within the external Yamaha CP power adapter. Let's identify its parts. On the left is the wall plug. It's connected to the 120-volt AC primary of the step-down transformer. The transformer secondary steps the voltage down by a factor of 10 to 1 and transforms the output voltage to 12 volts AC. The 12 volts AC from the transformer secondary, as measured between the red dots, is now applied to the next component to the right. The waveform of this voltage is shown in the chart. The next component is known as a bridge rectifier. It's comprised of four diodes arranged in a square and oriented in the manner shown. A diode is an electronic device that conducts electricity in one direction, but not the other. With this arrangement of diodes, the 12 volts AC waveform is rectified so that the negative half of the AC waveform is flipped to a positive orientation, as shown in the picture. The positive half of the AC waveform remains positive. This rectified waveform is applied to the next component in the circuit. The next component in the circuit is a capacitor, and it's indicated by an orange circle. When used in this way, it's known as a smoothing capacitor. A capacitor is an electronic component comprised of two closely spaced plates that are separated by a thin insulator. A capacitor will not conduct DC current between these two plates, but it can be connected between a charge conductor, in this case the output of the bridge rectifier, and chassis ground. These points are indicated by purple dots. Capacitors oppose changes in voltage across their plates. When a DC voltage is applied to a capacitor, its plates will charge to a value equal to the applied voltage. It acts like a temporary battery. If that DC voltage then decreases, the capacitor will discharge to maintain the previous voltage level. If the applied voltage fluctuates up and down, the capacitor will then charge and discharge because it opposes changes in voltage across its plates. When it does this, it smooths out the voltage fluctuations and stabilizes them. The resulting smoother waveform is shown in the picture by the thick black line. We'll look at this rippled output voltage in a moment. The last component in the circuit is the two-conductor cannon plug on the right. The filtered output of the plus 12 volts DC is connected to pin number 2. The chassis ground connection, or 0-volt reference ground, is connected to pin number 1. It's important to note that the chassis ground connection for the Yamaha CP power supply isn't made until the power supply is plugged into the piano. Later, I'll show you exactly where this connection is. You'll need to know its location if you want to measure any voltages inside the piano. This is a diagram of the output voltage of a Yamaha CP wall adapter. As you can see, it is not flat because its level changes rapidly. This is known as ripple. The capacitor smooths out the mountain-like waveform somewhat by discharging and charging when the voltage oscillates, and this is a vast improvement to the DC quality. However, the resulting DC is not yet ready to be used by the piano circuits. Ideally, the DC output should be ruler flat. The gold standard for ripple-free DCs is a simple battery, which has no ripple. Since battery power is impractical for this application, Yamaha decided to locate the regulator circuits inside the harp section and not in the external adapter. The wall adapters of the era when CPs were made had not yet evolved into the small, lightweight, and reliable switching power supplies that are common today. When we measured the DC voltage output of that rippled red line, we discover that it is in the range of about 19 volts DC. Why is this? Let's look at our diagram. The most important thing to note here is that this power supply isn't yet hooked up to the piano. This condition is known as unloaded, and it's critical to understand that an unregulated power supply will have a significantly higher output voltage when it's unloaded. How much the piano circuits load down the power supply will determine what voltage the power supply settles down to. In simple terms, there is nothing in the design of an unregulated power supply that regulates the voltage level other than how much demand is placed on it by the load, in this case, the piano's electronics. If the demand of the load goes up, the voltage will go down and vice versa. Once the external power supply is plugged into a fixed load, such as the piano, the voltage settles down to a static value. This is a schematic diagram of the entire power supply circuit of a Yamaha CP piano. The rectangle on the right is the combined external wall adapter and side panel, and the rectangle on the left is the internal regulator circuit. This is a picture of the side panel of a powered-up Yamaha CP80. You can see the power slide switch, indicator light, and mated cannon connectors. Yamaha specifies that the DC must be used in the range of 16 to 20 volts DC only. This is a picture of the back of the side panel of a Yamaha CP80. On top is the power slide switch. Beneath it is the red power indicator light, and on the right is the 2-pin cannon power connector. Notice how the black ground wire from the cannon connector is soldered to one terminal of the red indicator light. The orange wire on the other terminal is the power feed from the regulator board for that light. The rippled DC power enters the piano through the cannon connector indicated by the red circle on the right, with the plus DC power on pin number 2 and 0 volts DC or ground on pin number 1. The next component in the circuit is the on-off switch located on the side panel. Here it is indicated by an orange circle and arrow. From here, the plus DC voltage travels through the red wire on the slide switch, then onto the internal regulator board. The 0 volts ground is connected to a black wire, which is also connected to both the internal regulator circuit board and the metal frame of the harp section. This last connection is indicated by a green oval. This is the internal power supply regulator circuit board of the Yamaha CP series. Let's measure some DC voltages on it. We'll clamp the black or ground lead of a digital multimeter to the grounding screw located on the lower right-hand corner of the harp section shown in a white circle. This screw should be used whenever measuring voltage inside the piano. It's connected to the logical source of ground or 0 volts, the metal harp of the piano. We'll connect the red lead of the meter to the red middle terminal on the right side regulator circuit board as indicated by a blue circle. This is labeled plus 18. We measure almost 18 volts DC at this point, slightly less than the 19 volts DC we measured with the power supply unloaded. Here, the power supply is loaded down and its voltage has dipped slightly because we're making it work. We'll leave the black lead in place and clamp the red lead to the orange wire terminal on the regulator circuit board indicated by the green circle. This is the one labeled PL. Here, we measure about 1.6 volts DC. This is the voltage applied to the indicator lamp on the side panel. We'll leave the black lead in place and clamp the red lead to the yellow wire terminal on the left side of the regulator circuit board indicated by the blue circle. This one is labeled plus 16. Here we measure about 16 volts DC. This is one of the voltages applied to the tremolo circuit. With the black lead in place, we'll clamp the red lead to the white wire terminal on the left side of the regulator circuit board indicated by the white circle. This is the one labeled plus 8. Here we measure about 8 volts DC. This is the other voltage applied to the tremolo circuit. Still keeping the black lead in place, we'll clamp the red lead to the red wire terminal on the left side of the regulator circuit board as indicated by the orange circle. This one is labeled plus 12. Here we measure about 12 volts DC. This is the primary voltage for the preamplifier circuit. We'll look at other connections on the internal regulated circuit board. On the left side and labeled 0 is the 0 volt DC connection to the harp ground screw terminal made with a black wire. This connection establishes the 0 volt reference for all voltages inside the piano. And on the right side are two connections labeled E. The letter E stands for earth, and it's the designated earth ground for the tremolo and preamplifier circuits. They're connected to green wires. The upper green wire is the ground connection for the preamplifier circuit, and the lower green wire is the ground connection for the tremolo circuit. Direct current flows from the plus 12, plus 16, and plus 8 volt power supply connections to those circuits, then back to the ground connection through the green wires. Each green wire provides a return path for the DC current flowing from the power supply. This is the internal regulator circuit schematic for the Yamaha CP piano. It contains 14 discrete components that regulate the voltage and limit the current for the preamplifier and tremolo circuits. How does it do all that? We'll learn its design secrets in the next video. Thanks for watching!